The direction we were moving was clear now. Without wanting it, without even knowing it, we were becoming a gang.
Hey y'all, I hope you're doing well, awesome, wonderful, all of the good things. It's been a little while since I've uploaded an actual like art-related video, but we're back. I took a little brain break, it was nice. I got a new camera too, so hopefully there's a difference in quality. Anyway, as you can tell by the title, I've put together a guide for the Sharpie oil-based paint markers that I love so dearly. Like, there is so much love in my heart for these markers. I've been using them for a while, so it's about time that I made a video on how to use them, because they aren't entirely too popular, and I love sharing things with y'all. I've already done my sketch because I found that the proportions are a lot better when I do it off camera. Plus, y'all don't gotta see that, it's not really necessary for this tutorial. So I've drawn my good friend Lucy for this video, so Lucy, if you're watching this, hey! Let's talk about the actual material for a second though. I got these markers from Walmart because that's the only relatively close non-internet place that I can find them at, but they're probably at some other art stores like Michael's or something, hopefully. I would assume they're at Michael's, like that's a pretty solid assumption to make. They don't warp the paper because they're oil-based, and they are similar to Posca markers in the sense that they can make a really solid color. But I like these ones better because they don't pill at the paper and they're definitely more blendable, although they do bleed. Because of that, I would recommend using paper on the thicker side like mixed media, watercolor, or even marker paper just to prevent that bleeding or minimize it as much as possible. And these markers come in a set of primary colors plus black and white, and there's also another set of the same markers but thicker, and then a set of more vibrant colors like pink, orange, green, purple, pretty much all the colors that don't come with the primary set. So there's three different kind of options that you can roll with. I have all three because I love these markers, but yeah, pick whatever you think you would use. From a general artistic standpoint, I think of cool colors like blue and purple as shadows, and then warm colors like yellow as highlights. As many people do with painting, I start with my darkest areas. So I take a dark blue and fill things in like the eyes or any other shadows before starting on anything else. After that, I go on top with red to create a dark purple, which is the darkest color that I can make with a primary set that's not black. From this point on, I slowly fill in little details that are in close proximity to the dark spots. So for example, I started with the eyes with that dark blue and then the red, and then I added some pink around the eyelid and under the eye just to kind of build up from that. I don't really use these markers aiming for realism. I just put down the colors wherever I see them, and I don't exactly strive for accuracy. If there's a bit of pink on an area, I'll take the vibrant pink marker and put that down. This is something that I love when working with these markers because it's a bit looser than something like colored pencils or oil paint. It's a bit less meticulous. As far as blending goes, I found a pretty solid method, and you may have noticed me using it for the past minute or so. But basically, you can put a layer of the white marker wherever you plan to draw, and before it has too much time to dry, put down a color and then blend it again with the white. A lot of people use white to blend when they're using colored pencils, so I kind of took that knowledge and applied it here. It's not super easy to describe verbally, but if you keep an eye on the process I'm using to blend, you can get a pretty solid idea of what I'm doing. I use a layer of white first to make sure the color I'm putting down blends more easily, because if I don't put the white down beforehand, it kind of sticks to the paper more, and it's more difficult to blend out. So yeah, I sandwich it in between layers of white to blend it out. Your process with these markers can really be as all over the place or as technical as you want it to be. I tend to drift towards my colored pencil process when using these when it comes to colors, so I go for the more vibrant aspects of portraits. These also work well if you're a big fan of using layers. The markers aren't the most opaque when layered on top of each other, so you can actually get a wide range of options when blending. I know this could sound like a negative to some people, but personally, I love it. It's versatility, baby! What I also like about these markers is that if you mess up, it's really easy to cover things up with layers or to blend it out. Since they don't come with a brown or any kind of flesh tone, it also opens up your mind to different possibilities with colors, and it gets you more acquainted with mixing them. Overall, it's actually helped me learn about how certain colors blend with each other to make skin tones, or how skin tones have certain colors that I can bring out in a drawing, and when they dry, you get this nice and glossy, smooth texture. It's very nice. Chef's kiss. As y'all can probably tell by now, the process I use with these markers isn't really much different than how I would use any other drawing medium. It's all really in the layers and the details, and bringing out certain things like contrast and colors in the drawing, which kind of come to you as you practice with different materials, as one does. And if you've tried Posca markers, or you're looking for a slightly cheaper alternative, or you just want to try something new, I highly recommend these markers. For some reason, there's something about them that's like a happy medium to me. I can't really explain it, but when I go out and I want to bring something to draw with, I'll bring these markers. Like, these are my first choice. Colored pencils are a little too pretentious. They can break easily if you bring them somewhere. Pencils like graphite are too boring to me. And pens are alright, but they feel a little limiting, and these markers just hit the spot. Like, I can go babysit and let the kids use them without worrying about them getting ruined, but at the same time, after they go to sleep, I can make a bomb-ass drawing, you know what I'm saying? There's not entirely too much to say about these markers. I know they're used for graffiti sometimes because they are paint markers. I've also seen them at school being used for making posters and whatnot. They are pretty versatile, but I don't see many people using them for just making illustrations on paper or in their sketchbooks. I think the most helpful piece of advice I have for these markers is to constantly find ways to incorporate every single color you have. Try and push the contrast as much as you can, and use a lot of layers. And those three things are what I find myself saying a lot when it comes to tutorial videos like this, but they're honestly the most important part for me when it comes to making art. It does take some time and practice to get the hang of these markers and learn how to blend with them, but the main points still stand. As you may have noticed, skin tones are mainly made up of yellow, pink, red, or orange when I use these markers, and hair tends to be more blue or purple. It really depends though. In some reference pictures, if you use reference pictures, you may notice there are blue, purple, or green undertones in skin depending on the lighting, the tone of the skin, any factors like those. And as time progresses, you may find it less necessary to blend colors in certain areas. Using the sandwiching in layers of white marker process is helpful when blending in the beginning of the drawing versus towards the end of it or during the bulk of it. As helpful as some verbal advice is, the most important thing with these markers is really just feeling them out, because I feel like everyone uses them a bit differently. And I know I had some tips for y'all, and they could be helpful, but remember, there's no one single way to use them, because everyone's got their different processes. And as a reminder, as per usual in these type of videos, I want to make it crystal clear that I'm not an expert. I'm just sharing art, sharing what I know, in hopes of maybe sparking some inspiration or helping anyone out there in some shape or form. So take my tips with a grain of salt, and if you do happen to get or own these markers, I advise you do some experimenting to really find your own unique process with these, because they are so fun to use. I don't know why, I just love them so much. I'm gonna shut up for a bit because I've said a pretty substantial amount. Enjoy the drawing process. I'll be back towards the end. Thank you. Hey, I'm back. I hope you enjoyed the last 2 minutes or so. Right now I'm working on the hair, which is just layering different colors on top of each other over and over and over. I really like to use a lot of different colors on the hair. I know it looks a little crazy, a little colorful, but hey, just in time for Pride Month, am I right? Fuck out my way when you see me. I'm rolling with the LGBT. Hopefully you've gotten somewhat of a grasp with these markers. I don't know about y'all, but I'm a pretty visual learner, so when I see process videos like these, it helps a lot. There's not too much to do from here. I'm just adding little details and whatnot, and some last touches of eyelashes, extra marks for texture, some last minute highlights, anything like that. Anything to really finalize the piece. Towards the end is also where I add some more green and blue towards the face, wherever it feels right. Adding those little details just helps tie it together. This is a bonus, but you can also use a white Posca pen or anything similar, like a gel pen or just a good solid white marker to add those shiny highlights. I always add some to the eyes, nose, lips, hair, and anywhere else it feels necessary. As we're coming to the close of this video, I wanted to say it's been a bit harder to find motivation these days, so I really am trying to get back into the groove of things. I know I haven't uploaded in 3 weeks, and I usually upload like once a week or once every 2 weeks. This video hasn't been the most requested, but a few of you guys asked for it, and this was one of the few videos that I actually kind of wanted to do, so hopefully this was helpful or you enjoyed it at the very least, and please don't hesitate to let me know of any art videos that you want to see from me. I want to make content specifically for you guys. I love you guys so much. Speaking of y'all, we hit 60k recently? That's insane, especially since I haven't been consistently uploading, so thank you guys for wanting to stick around. And of course I had to get that good TikTok video. So yeah, from this point on, I just drew the background purple, and you can really see how solid of a color you can get with these markers if you really want. So yeah, I just really like them because you can blend or do a solid color, or like both, you know? Real versatile. Anyway, here's the finished product. It's not the best, but I hope you guys liked it. Lucy, I hope you liked it. And yeah, pretty much it. Follow me on Instagram if you want, or on TikTok, and I hope you enjoyed. Have a wonderful day. I love you guys so, so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye. Love you.